Okay, now we're going to do a little bit of arm work on the foam roller, as well as some additional core centering work. So we're going to take light dumbbells, and just so you know, if you have any kind of shoulder issues or whatever, these exercises are perfectly well done and effective to do without dumbbells. So holding the dumbbells, if you want, take your arms straight to the ceiling, and she's going to do the oppositional arm. So one arm goes over the head slowly, the other arm goes down toward the floor, and then you bring them back to the center. So what you want to feel is that the arms are being held from the center of the body, from like where your diaphragm is and from the center of your back. Inhale as you reach them away, exhale, bring them back to the center. Just going to do like 8 of these. So again, you don't want to go to the full range of motion. You don't want to take the arm all the way to the floor over your head. Yeah, you want to stop it when it gets about the line of your body. And this actually makes you work your core better than doing a greater range of motion. And she might not look like it, but she's told me that she definitely feels this in her abdominals. It's sort of like ribcage arms, where you take both arms over the head and come back, connecting, keeping that connection in the underarm and the ribs. Okay, now she's going to do flies. She's going to round the elbows a little bit, open the arms out, open them just a little bit past maybe the line of the body, but not too far, and then bring them back to the center. Good. And as she opens, she keeps those ribs down, and that makes it a core exercise. She's also drawing the shoulder blades down the back, right, keeping her head and neck relaxed. And breathing. Oh, just nice and easy. Nice little, she has a nice relaxed grip on the dumbbell, so she's not creating any tension in the hands or the wrists, which would translate up into the, possibly up into the neck and shoulders. Let's do one more time. Good. Now keeping her right arm to the ceiling, she's gonna set the left arm down and let go of the dumbbell so she can just touch the floor for a little balance. And then she's gonna draw her left leg up to the ceiling. Good. And so now we're gonna do oppositional arm to leg. So she's going to reach the arm overhead as the leg lowers to the floor, flex the foot as you lower, and then point and reach the leg to come back up to the ceiling. Good. And we're just going to do this 6 times. Inhale, exhale, come back to the ceiling. Good. All right, let's do one more. Good. Now from here, she's going to work a little bit laterally. She's going to open the arm out to the side and the leg out to the side, matching the angle of the arm and the leg. So you have to restrict and then come back to straight up and down. So the tendency will be for your arm to go out farther because it has more range of motion than your leg. And you just have to restrict that arm because you want the weight of the arm and the leg counterbalancing each other. One more time. Pause for a second. Feel that counterbalance from the center. And then come back to the middle. Good. Now she's going to go across. This one's harder. Keep your balance. Feel the arm and the leg falling away and then come back. Good. And again, crossing the center line. Back slowly to the ceiling. Don't go too fast, especially when you return back to the ceiling, because you may open. Don't open. That's it. One more time. Go across. Cross, cross. Exploring that range and come back and switch. Excellent. And then she changes arms and legs. Straight to the ceiling. And then here we go, oppositional arm to leg on the vertical plane and come back. That's one. Two. And now here's where she's going to open slowly to the side, very whole, very small, restricted range of motion, and then come back to the center. And again, open. And back to the ceiling. One more time, open, not too far. And to the ceiling. And now going across the center line. Oh, she has to do one more. She's doing 4. I'm messing up. She did it perfect. And then go across. And back to the ceiling. Good. And there's a little, you know, chance that you may lose a little bit of your balance here if you go too far. And if that happens, you've got your arm on the floor, you've got your foot on the floor, you're not gonna, you know, fall too far. You'll just maybe fall a little bit off the roller. You're gonna have to center yourself. That's okay. You want to, you know, kind of play with that and challenge it a little bit. Is that four?
Yes.
Okay. And then set the foot down. And lastly, for just to stretch the shoulders. And again, if you have any shoulders issue, you could do this without the dumbbells. She's gonna take the arms up overhead and allow them to go ahead and come to the floor to get that stretch and drag them around with the palms facing up. This feels so good. If there was only one exercise to do on your back and the foam roller, this would probably be one of the best ones that anyone would want to do. But again, it really depends on you, depends on your shoulders. Notice she's letting the elbows bend and really releasing through. And then reverse. This one's a little trickier, don't be a little careful. And notice she keeps the arms shoulder width when she comes back. Don't cross, it's better not to cross the arms in front of your chest, which will tend to round your shoulders. This way she maintains a broadness across the collarbones by drawing those arms just shoulder width parallel. One more time. Breathing. And bring it back. Good, let the dumbbells down. Take a breath now. You can just use your arms to help you. You're going to exhale and roll up to sitting. Push with the arms. Good. Now you were lying down on your back for a while, so she's just going to take a cross sit, easy position, and just allow her circulation and her balance to just come back to center. And you want to do this for, you know, about 30 seconds or so. Take a breath. Feel your focus come back. Okay. Laleh, thank you very much. Namaste.